so long. Now I finally found someone to stand by me.
Where'd you go?
For a walk.
2 in the morning?
I was hot.
We're having a heat wave, okay? Great idea for a song.
It is so hot in here, I don't know how you can sleep.
He's dreaming of Tab Hunter. You want him? I'll take Troy Donahue.
Why do we always talk about men? You know, we should be talking about our plans for the future.
That involves men.
Is that all you ever think about?
Sometimes I think about makeup.
Maybe a person could sleep if somebody would turn the music down.
Do you mind telling me why you're acting so nuts so that maybe I can go back to sleep?
I don't know. I just don't feel like I belong.
You really that unhappy here?
I'm just all tense.
Yep. Johnny.
Boom!
And now for
over here. Move, move! Three strikes and you're out.
I'm sorry.
All right. Who's ever got table 11? The Wyatts are salivating for their blueberry pancake. And whoever spilled the maple syrup all over Jack and Elaine Gable is fired.
I'm sorry.
Oh, well, just see if you can get the food on their plates this time.
Try.
Please. I'm going through these ad assets like candy.
Pick up the short stack.
Listen, honey, we're charging the guests extra this weekend on account of Red Buttons coming up, so I want everybody to be happy. Very, very happy.
Okay? Yeah.
Would somebody clean up this mess, please?
What the short stack? Hey,
Sheila, will you take over, please?
My husband doesn't begin to know how to lead the way you do.
It's just instinct. When a man takes a woman in his arms, what's he have to know?
You know, I was thinking, I'd really love to have another private lesson.
It'd be my pleasure, Mrs. Rick.
Evelyn.
And slow, quick, slow, dip.
By the way, just thought I'd mention, my husband's opening a new review in his hotel in Las Vegas this fall.
Really?
And he's coming up here tonight to catch Red Buttons. Wouldn't it be brilliant of me to let him discover you?
Very brilliant. I'll tell you what, my last class is at 5. I'll get Penny together and we'll show him what we can do, huh?
Well, if you just keep doing what you do, Johnny, you'll be just fine.
What does he see in her?
Money. Can you hand me those thumbtacks over there?
He's gonna ruin his whole life.
And yours too. You know, there is Sky in free law at table 6.
I am not interested.
Just take your mind off of Mr. Excitement.
I wouldn't care if all the future doctors and lawyers of America came to Kellerman's. I'm about up to here with this whole male-female thing.
Where are you going?
I don't know. I just want to be by myself.
You're by yourself 8 whole hours every night when you go to sleep. That's not enough?
I'll send you a postcard.
cause you're all alone. And nobody calls you on the phone. Don't you feel like a cry? Don't you feel like crying? Well, here I am, honey. Come on, you cry to me. When you're all alone in your lonely room, and there's nothing but the smell of her perfume, don't you feel like a cry? Don't you feel like crying? Don't you feel like a cry? Come on, come on.
See, it's like this. Red Button's train is getting in at 3 o'clock, and I begged Max to let me pick him up, but Myrna Glass, the heartbreaker from Fort Lee, finally said she'd go out with me. I haven't had a date yet this summer, and I think I'm in love, or lust, or something. But anyhow, would you do it?
Look, Norman, I'd like to help you out, but we're rehearsing here for a gig I have at 6.
Yeah, but it'll only take an hour. Look, Myrna and I'll name our first child after you. Little Johnny Jr.
Okay, okay, you're a poor sucker.
You're a saint.
Please don't let it be him. Please don't let it be him. God, it's him. Why? Why are you doing this to me, God?
Ugh. Hey, what are you doing out here?
What are you doing out here?
Taking a shortcut to pick up Red Buttons at the train station? Come on, get in. I'll give you a ride.
No, I'll walk.
Oh, it's crazy. It's too hot. Besides, it's a long way back.
I'll survive.
What, are you running away from home or something?
I wanted to just take a walk, okay?
Does your old man know you're out here all alone?
I suppose you think I'm too young to take a walk without reporting in?
Look, you better get back in the car.
Why? You know, I'm fine. I'm just trying to enjoy myself out here, alone with nature.
This isn't nature. This is a deserted back road. It's snakes, bears.
Come on. Yeah, I'm a big girl.
So I've noticed. Except all the other big girls usually like it when I offer them a ride in my car. Come on, I'm gonna be late.
For all your private lessons?
What do you know about that?
Well, when a man takes a woman in his arms, it's instinct. It's you, Miss Ginsburg. You and your rich husband.
What, you go around spying on the help?
Is that the way the rich guests pay you to speak to them?
No, actually, they pay me for this.
Johnny, put me down!
Well, I'm glad you're having a nice time. Be sure and get that best suit pressed now. Red Buttons is on his way. You're gonna have the funniest night of your life.
Phone call for you, Max.
Thank you. Hello. Red. Red, where are you? Ah, come on. I know you're just outside your big kidder. Listen, we've had to turn people away, the whole... Whoa, wait a minute. I got guests living for this moment, not to mention paying for it. Look, maybe we could... Well, what about... You're booked until New Year's Eve? Oh, boy. No problem. I'll just sell the place. I'm a dead man.
Why are you so damn angry with me? What did I do?
Nothing. I don't know.
It's this Mrs. Ginsburg thing, isn't it? Look, it's my job, okay? I keep them happy. I get good tips. That's why I was hired. That's all there is to it. And what do you care anyway what I do? What, are we married or something?
God forbid.
Yeah, my feelings exactly. Great. Just great.
What?
Look. Don't say a word, okay?
Well, what's wrong?
Well, we're not moving, that's for starters.
Are you telling me we're stuck?
Not if you know anything about fixing engines.
Well, I don't.
You will. Hold this.
How long is this gonna take?
Yeah, well, if you hadn't lost the rotor, we'd be driving back.
I didn't lose it. You dropped it, probably.
Great, fine. Blame me. Whatever makes you happy, okay?
Hey, look. There's a cabin up there.
What about it?
Well, why don't we go up there and rest for a while?
Sure, why not? Red Buttons has only been sitting at the train station for, 3 or 4 hours. He can wait a little longer.
Okay, never mind.
Come on, we'll rest, okay? We'll sit down.
I don't know if I want to sit down in there.
What's wrong with it?
Well, it's spooky.
Hey, look. If it weren't for you, I'd be one step closer to Vegas by now. But no. I'm on a stupid road in the stupid mountains because I was stupid enough to pick you up. So get in there and sit down.
All right, I'm going.
Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you look great. What can I tell you? Now, I know you've got your heart set on seeing Red Buttons. I got a call from Red. Appendix attack. He's in surgery right now. I know. My prayers are with him, too. what's going to happen is this. We've come up with a plan. And I know you're going to love it. Right here on our stage tonight, the guests of Kellerman in a talent contest. The winner to be flown to Las Vegas to see Red Button's show live at the Sands Hotel.
Way to go, Johnny. You lose your job and a chance of a lifetime all in one day.
My father is not going to fire you. Why do you need rich ladies' husbands giving you chances?
Look, would you get off my case with this Mrs. Ginsburg thing? You know what it's like between me and her? Come here, I'll show you. Oh, Mrs. G, you're my favorite pupil. You float in my arms. How could I go through the week without you? You think that's what I'm about? You think everyone should act like those heroes you read about in your books?
I don't even like heroes. Yeah, I like people with flaws.
Oh, yeah, that's funny.
Why?
Because the perfect girl usually goes for the perfect guy. It's just a rule. So why aren't you sitting down?
There's no place to sit.
I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
I got a blanket in the car.
Johnny, hurry back, okay?
Okay.
A coin trick. It always worked before, but you'll love this one. And now my assistant and lovely wife, Bertha Stein, will hand me a glass.
See? Just a glass. An empty glass. Just like the kind you would use in your own home.
Bertha, that's enough. Please.
Well, excuse me, Mr. Showbiz.
And now she will fill the glass with water. Folks, this is real water. And now we will turn the glass upside down. You don't believe it, huh? Watch this. You're the one that's supposed
to... Let's give these two lovebirds a big hand and thank you, sir.
change the way other people see us. You're the bad boy. I'm the good girl. No matter what we do. But there's a little of both. Both of us. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know.
I have a confession to make. I am really flawed. I was kicked out of Girl Scouts. I didn't turn in all the money I made on Girl Scout cookies.
I don't know if I can adjust. So what do you want to do? We could walk back or spend the night.
I mean...
You don't seem too thrilled about walking in the dark, so we could sleep here. Walk back tomorrow.
Oh. Okay. That's fine. So let's get some sleep.
Great. Good night, baby.
My friend Sam here is a traveling salesman. He keeps me in his briefcase. Sometimes when he shows a customer his samples, I pop out instead.
Johnny. Are you asleep?
No.
I was just thinking, what good are heroes in books anyway? I mean, they certainly haven't helped me. At least you know something about yourself. I don't even know what I'm gonna do.
You'll find out.
Yeah, but people are always expecting so much, you know, parents.
Yeah.
I think you should be able to try on a couple of different personalities before you finally become who you're supposed to be.
Yeah. Everyone thinks they've got you pegged. Sometimes I think it would be easier for me just to tell my old man that I'm gonna take over his garage. And I'll have nothing to worry about.
That wouldn't be easy.
Yes, it would.
No, it wouldn't. Because you've got a gift. I mean, you were probably born with it. The only thing I can remember doing well as a child was making Mr. Potato Heads.
Well, Max, we'd like to do our Lucy impression.
Oh, that's cute. Which one of you does Lucy?
Well, Max, we all do. We do the entire show, actually. And we all take all the different parts.
Swell.
So what do you think it's going to be like tomorrow?
What do you mean?
I mean, when we get back, my father's got a really wild imagination. He'll think
but
that
we know better.
I know, but right now everybody's wondering.
Baby,
at least it'll add a little mystery to my life.
It's not that I don't think you're very... Because you are.
You are too.
What am I gonna do with you?
I don't know.
I mean, we can, and I will, and that's why we have to get out of here. Baby, I can't spend the night here alone with you. Do you understand?
Yes.
Think you could walk it back?
Yeah.
You think anyone will believe nothing happened?
You?
I'll see you in another lifetime.
Mrs. Fisher, thank you so much. Well, that's our show, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, who says you need red buttons? We got our own stars right here. Now, our judges are making the selection, and we'll announce the winner tomorrow at breakfast. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you, thank you. Well, didn't you just love it?
Yeah.
I mean, I had them eating out of my hand.
It was so wonderful.
They didn't even know we were gone.
I know, I can't.
I waited. Where were you?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Ginsburg. My car broke down.
Well, so did our deal.
Did she seem a little unfriendly to you?
Are you upset?
It's done. Come on.
Did I feel a breeze?
Yeah, I think the heat finally broke. Well, I'll walk you home.
I think maybe we should say goodnight here.
Smart woman.
Johnny.
Yeah.
I'll see you.
Good night, baby.